So with the recent changes to Redbubble and TeePublic, the categories and tiers, it's more important now to market your designs on social media platforms to get more traffic. And that's because, especially on TeePublic, they're not showing your designs in the marketplace, right? They want you to drive traffic if you're in the apprentice category. Now, there's different ways to get out of the apprentice category, and this is one of them, is to get some sales, and that is to drive traffic with posts on social media like Instagram, Twitter or X, Facebook, and so on. And there's so many different sizes for that, so it's really hard to keep track of it. But in Kittle, you can do multiple artboards and have them all in one place. I'm gonna show you how to create marketing or posts for a sale on TeePublic, and you can use it for any thing, not just a sale, but I'll show you how to do it and do it for multiple sizes for different social media posts. So you can have your Instagram stories on there as well as your Instagram posts, and a Twitter size and a Facebook size and so on, just so you have it all together so they all look the same, and you can put it and post it on the same day to different social media platforms. So this can work really well. So I'm gonna go into Kittle first and show you where to do that and how to do that. There's also some templates on there. I'll leave those templates in the description so you can use those templates as well. You don't have to start from scratch, and we're not gonna start from scratch either. And I'm gonna put mine up there as well so that you have another one that you can use. So let's go to Kittle right now and I'll show you how to do all of this. All right, so here we are on Kittle, kittle.com. You can see they have tons of templates for tons of different things, t-shirts, logos, all of it. But what you may not have known is there's also one for marketing. So right here it says, do you want to create some for marketing or social or stationary on all of these? So I'm going to click on marketing, and these are ads, right? Some of them are ads, but some of them are posts too. So let's see this one right here. You can see there's multiple posts for Instagram. That's one. We may use that one. Let's see if we can find another one. Here, another carousel post, right, for Instagram. What we're looking for are multiple ones, and I'm going to put a link in. I found about five or six of them because they're all mashed up here with different things. You can see this is a media kit, this is an ad and so on. This is another like magazine ads. They're all kind of mixed together. I'm going to put in my descriptions the one that I'm going to use or different ones that I've found. But let me see if I can scroll some more and see if there's other ones. Here's another one right here for Instagram posts. You can see they're different sizes. So I'm just gonna use the one that I found on top, and I'll show you how it works. So I'm gonna click on this one, and it's gonna upload it, and you're gonna notice that there's gonna be multiple artboards. So let's look at that. So here's the thumbnail that we saw, but you can see this is artboard one, artboard two, artboard three, which the different sizes that might work out for Instagram and so on. And here's another one that I found that's more relatable because it has t-shirts in it. So I'm gonna click on this one too, use this design. And you can see this one also has them with the different sizes. So Instagram square, Instagram portrait, Instagram story, Instagram landscape, and the thumbnail that we can see on Kittle. This was just made so that we can see, people who are browsing through can see the different sizes for Instagram ads. So there's different ways to do this. Now, if you had another size that you wanted to do, you could just click on here, make it the size that you want by clicking here. They have some other sizes right on here. Instagram posts we already have, but Facebook posts, we could do that. And we could do Facebook posts. And what was it? I forgot. 1200 by 1200, right? So we'll just find the same thing right here. 1200 by 1200. Boom, so now you have a lot of different sizes, and I can use this to make that. Now let me show you how to do some of these things on here. So what you might wanna do in this case, if you're using this one, to do two mockups. So you can do mockups in Kittle too. So if I hit mockup here, it's gonna try and mock up these things. What you wanna do is open up one of your designs. So we're gonna save this. It's already saved because I made a change to it. So I'm gonna go back to here and go direct to my profile. So you can see it's saved right there. Now I'm gonna do a mock-up of these two things, right? So these are my latest two designs. I'm gonna come in here, click on it. And I already did a mock-up here, but I'm gonna get rid of this one so you can see what it looks like. I'm gonna click on here, maybe this dark one right here, and hit mock-up. Now it's gonna bring up the mock-up settings and things, so you can do it on different products, not just t-shirts, but it like put it on a t-shirt by default. Now we want one with a person on it, so I'll hit show all. And there's a bunch right here. We can use them. And let's use the same person that I used last time here. And it's really easy. You can just size your design right here. And it already takes into account the folds and the colors and the shadows and highlights and everything, right? And so all I have to do is just put it in the right area like that, and done. I can hit click on here and hit download mockup, and it's goes to my downloads folder. Now we can do another one. Let's go back to editor. Maybe we want to do just the same one right here, but in the white version on a white t-shirt. I can come back here, go to mockup again, right, and put it on a white t-shirt. Let's go back to the people, and maybe it's this guy right here, right? Let's make it like the same size as the was on hers. Boom. All right, so now I can download this mockup too. Now I have two mockups, and I can bring those two mockups back into that template that we saw. So here I am back on this. Let's see what it looks like. So I'm gonna open up my downloads and just drag it in here. So here's the first one. You can come in here, make it the same size, cover that up. In fact, I can get rid of these two. Boom. And bring in the other one. She is. Boom. Now if you want the picture a little bigger to more focus on the design, you can come in here. You can see the cropped feature right here, and I can crop it in even closer, something like that, and then make this bigger, right? So now we have a closer view of the t-shirt. Now we can crop it some more if it's too long to match. Boom. And we can use those two things in here. Now, of course, you're going to change this and change this. We could maybe you don't have a new drop, you have a sale and so on. So you can change these things as well. So let me show you some things that I would do to change this. Let's say you're selling this on TeePublic. We might want to use some TeePublic logos and some TeePublic words and put it in here and change it. So let's do that right now. I'm going to go to TeePublic and a newsletter from TeePublic and get some assets. All right, so here we are on TeePublic, and we're going to use some of these assets. So if there is a sale on TeePublic, which there isn't one now, there might be a sale thing right here, and I'll show you what it looks like in the email that I got. But let's say it's right here, and maybe we're doing a dad t-shirt and we want to use some of their elements. You can do, if you're on a Mac, do Command-Shift-4, and you'll come up with this right here. And this is kind of like a screenshot grabber. So I'm going to come in here and just screenshot this mount right here. And you should hear a click. And I don't know what it is. I'm guessing it's kind of the same thing on a PC, but there is that where you can just take a screenshot. And I could use this as well, this TeePublic logo, but it's really small. So I'm going to just go and search on Google for TeePublic logo and click on this one. And this is a black version, but I want a white on black. So this one right here, I'm just going to grab it and drag it to my desktop. We'll use that later. And here's an email that I got for the sale. So this is 5 days ago when there was actually a sale. And I'm going to do the same screenshot thing right here, Command-Shift-4, and use this one. So I'm going to grab this right here. So I have those three assets. We're going to go back into Kittle and use those. So here I am on Kittle. I'm going to get rid of some of this right here on the bottom, and I'm going to drag in my TeePublic logo first. So here we are. And you can easily do it in Kittle. You can drag in assets, and you can see this is a PNG that's transparent, and I can do something like that. Now I can also drag in some of my other stuff that I did a screenshot of. So this one right here, which is a sale. Now it has all that background, but guess what? We have remove background, the AI background remover. I'm just going to click that, and hopefully it's going to clean this up. Yes. And so you can see I can use that right there. And then I'm going to use the other one. Same thing. Come in here. Now, if this was a dad shirt, I could use it and do the AI background remover, and you can see it works perfectly. So you can use stuff like that. And you can see everything's on sale. Well, let's do something like that. All caps. Now it's too big, right? So let's size it down. Now maybe everything is on sale is too many words. So we can say something like $16 tees or t-shirts, right? Just play around with it. Now you can make it bigger, or you could even say $16 tees to make it even bigger. Look at that. Right, and now it looks like at TeePublic, and you can put your shop name down here as well. So if you want to just come in here and type something, we'll just add a headline, right? Make sure it's white. You can do like visit my store. We can use upper lowercase store at, and well, we got to spell that correctly. But if we go to my store in TeePublic, let's see. You're gonna notice your name, your URL at the store here. This is mine, tpublic.com/detourshirt. So we can put all of that in, and we type all of that, and it's kind of long, but people know, and they can't really click on it on the post, but at least they can remember it. There you go. Look at that. Pretty cool, right? And then you do it for the different sizes. We're not gonna do it here, but you would do it for the different sizes, and then you can just download these. So when I click on here, you can hit download, and let me show you what that looks like. 1080 by 1080, don't worry about the DPI, that should be fine. Remove background, we don't wanna remove background. Optimize, sure, let's do that, and I'm gonna hit download. And now this can be an Instagram square on your Instagram. I'll show you how to upload that right now too. Okay, so here I am on Instagram. This is the desktop version. You're probably gonna use Instagram on your phone, but I'll show you how to do it on the desktop. So I'm gonna hit create, I'm gonna hit post, and then we just drag in that post. Boom, there it fits perfectly, right? I hit next, and then I'm gonna wanna type in, there is a sale on whatever, at TeePublic, go visit my store. Here are my two new designs. Now you don't have to limit yourself to two because we just followed what the template was, but you could put a bunch more designs. And in fact, I'm gonna share one that I did with a bunch more designs after this. But you can see, really easy. And this might be something you wanna do when there's a next sale. You don't wanna do it all the time. But what's cool is whenever you add a new design to TeePublic, it is on sale. So this could work anytime. You might wanna take this up to 35% off, but I guess it is up to 35% off the regular price anyway. So you could say, my new designs on TeePublic, $16, right? Something like that. And type it in here and then hit share. It's just that easy. And you're gonna see that it's gonna post up here. And I'll take it off of my real one, but you're gonna see what it looks like here. So let's click on here and refresh this. And there you go, $16 tees. Doesn't that look cool? That looks a lot better than just a t-shirt with nothing on it, right? So, and then you can do this for multiple socials. You can have a whole social media presence on Instagram and on Facebook and on Twitter and post it on different spots with the right size on here already. So one last thing before I go, I made this for you guys. It's the TeePublic sale post, I guess, five different TeePublic posts that you could use. You can see I made it a little bit different, and I made it with mask here, so you can just drop in your stuff. And let me show you how you can save some of your designs. I made a preview here with some of mine, but I'll show you how to do it with yours. So first, if you created your designs in Kittle, for example, like this one I created in Kittle, I'm gonna export this. I'm gonna come in here, download, and then you can see PNG and so on. And I could make it a square size if I wanted to, but I could just download it like this as well. And I'm gonna hit download, and it's gonna save it to there. You could also, it's gonna save it to the downloads page, but you could also go to TeePublic, and if you have some of your designs here that you didn't make in Kittle, you could come in here and you could screenshot these as well. So I'm gonna just hit Command plus plus just to make it bigger, and I'm gonna do Command Shift 4 again, and then do like a screenshot of one of these. So I'm gonna come in here and then kind of get to the edge here and like that. And that's gonna save to my desktop. So let's try both of these on this post thing. So I saved one here as a as an example. So you just drag it in here, boom, it locks it to that frame. So we can come in here, that mask. Now let's try some of the other ones from my downloads, right? That kicking one, I'm gonna come in here and it's gonna save it. You can see it's loading right there. It's gonna take a little while because it's really big. I saved it as a really big size. I probably should have saved it as a smaller size, but there you go. There it is. Now, if it's not centered, you can double click on it and move it till it's centered like this, right? Boom. Now you can also do the one that I just did a screenshot from TeePublic. So let's do that. I'll just drag it in here. And you can see it's gonna also take a little while, but it's not as big. And if you ever wanna remove these, you can come in here and hit release mask, and it's released, and I can put it somewhere else. Maybe I wanna put it there instead. Release mask, move it around, put it there instead. So really cool. I'm gonna release mask on all of these and just have the mask for you here. So you can see that mask was released. I can put it anywhere I want, or I could delete it. Let me do that again. Click on it, delete it here, release mask, click on it, delete it. So really easy. These masks are here to help you, and you can put up to 6 designs here. I think some of them are have only 4, but this is the different ones I have. So Instagram, X, and TikTok, the square version, 180 by 180, that works for that. If you're doing on Facebook, they have a different square for some reason. I think this would still work, but this one's a different 1200 by 1200. You can see they look identical. There's the portrait view for Instagram and X. I have it here. Facebook also has a different portrait view. This one's a little taller. And this will work for your stories for Facebook, for IG, for Instagram, and TikTok. So this is the story mode, the Reels side size, and that would work right there. And I think I left a lot on the bottom because there's usually stuff on the bottom that you can't read. So I put everything at the top, just so that people can see that right away and not, doesn't get lost. So there you go, 5 different ones for a TeePublic sale. Now again, if you have brand new designs, they're on sale, right? So I think they're on sale for at least 2 days, and you can put them and share what you've done. Now you can also wait for TeePublic sales. They usually have them twice a month. So once they're there, then grab your designs that you wanna highlight and put them in these frames. And you can use this over and over again, right? So you can use this and change this. Make sure to put your store name in here. I put your store. You're gonna have to edit that. Just click on here, type in, like for example, if it was Detour Shirts, I could put Detour Shirts right on there. So make sure to change that. You don't want it to just say your store on here. But yeah, I think this could really help. Make sure to get some sales or drive traffic to your shop. Now you still have to have really good designs that people want to buy, but this is another way to get some traffic. So there you go. Hopefully these are really helpful for you for marketing. Now remember, I'll put more links in the description to some of the other ones. You don't have to use mine. You can use some of the other ones that I found on there and kind of change it. That's what's great about Kittle, is that there's templates and you can change things about the templates, the colors, the fonts, and the pictures, and put it in there. You can use your own mock-ups as well as just the designs too. So change it up. Don't do it the same every time, but I think this can help you get some more posts and drive traffic to your t-shirt shops, hopefully get you some sales as well. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more about the multiple artboards on Kittle, I know I went pretty fast on there. This one kind of goes over it a lot better. Check it out. You can see how to use multiple artboards on Kittle to help you with some other things as well. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.